This is a water valve from the recycled washing machine. You can see I've already loosened two screws here. Its power source is 220 to 240 volt and 50 hertz. Our screws are here. Pulling the water valve out and no need that. This black thing, which is a magnet solenoid. That is all we need. Connecting the power of live and neutral, which is black in color, to the magnet solenoid's two pins. Plug the power cord in multi-socket set, but not switch on it yet. This screwdriver has no magnet force and is unable to pick a screw up. Switch the power on. Then put the screwdriver's tip into the center hole of the solenoid. And stay there about 10 seconds. Switch the power off. Then pull the screwdriver out. Its tip can pick a screw up. The screwdriver's tip has been magnetic now. Try it again. Pretty good, hey. Now to do as showing in the video. The screwdriver is unable to pick a screw up, so its tip is not magnetic anymore. This is a high voltage capacitor used in microwave oven. That is an AC 220 to 240 volt capacitor. And this one is a DC 450 volt capacitor used in the circuit board. For the part of the circuit board here, taking this capacitor as an example. Plug the power cord in the sockets. Switched the power on, then off. Now using a multimeter's DC function to measure the capacitor's voltage between its terminals. Volt can be seen from the meter after the power was off. Discharging from the capacitor must be done before working on the circuit board. And by using a globe to do as showing. That's it. To measure the capacitor's voltage again after discharged, just for a double check. It was 41 volt. and safe to work on the circuit board. This is the best way to discharge a capacitor. By using a globe with the rating of 220 to 240 volt and 60 to 120 watt in this case. Do one more time. Now you've known how to properly and safely discharge a capacitor. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please thumb up. Your encouragement is my further motivation.